Good morning, students. Today I am going to start combustion and flame. Combustion and flame. This is a very general and very useful, important for chemistry as well as our general life. To understand the combustion, we are going to talk about first about fire. At ancient time, when there was no fire, there are so many problems created for their food, because the foods which the forest peoples are taking, that foods are only raw foods which is not cooked. And also, they are not, since they are the these foods are not cooked, so there are the so many problems created. Now the what happened when there was no fire was there, at that time the major problems are created, not only for the cooking food but also for lighting and heating purpose. That time, if fire was not there, at that time the light also, heat was not there. So there are the so many generous problems are in the their life. After some times, due to the food and shelters, the forest people moving here and there, and during that times, what happens? They are rubbing the kind of the stone, hitting one two stones together. At night time they observe some kind of the fire crack. There are some type of fire crack, and with that fire crack, what they did, they collected some kind of the dry hay, and nearby this dry hay, they rub stone nearby this dry hay. They rub the 2-3 stones, and with that rubbing, because of the high frictions, this rubs this stone created fire, and because of that fire it gets burning. It is, these hairs are start burning, and after this is the first time when the people observe some kind of the burning take place. And with this with the help of this kind of the observation, the people getting start the burning process. And after this burning process, now these people are getting raw food into cooked food. And also, not only when the fires burn, when the substance burn, it not only produce light but also create heat nearby. And with the help of this kind of the things, the fires comes into the picture. And when the fires take place, 1879, Thomas Edison, had discovered bulb, and with the help of bulb, as we know, today's scenario, as we know, with the help of the light, where we can see many kind of the things at night. After this discovery, the many more things happened, and so on, things worked on the, this kind of the things. And today there are the some digital and manual things are present by which we can fire the substances, like matchsticks and lighter. These are the things by which we can fire substances and cook our food, as well as the take lights and heat. So this is the basic things to require this combustion. So with this kind of the pictures, we can understood that how much fires is important for our daily life. Now I am going to talk about the combustible substance and non-combustible substance. The combustible substance combustible and non combustible substance. Basically, combustible substance are those kind of the substance which get fired easily, which get which catch fire easily. Like paper, petrol, diesel, kerosene, wood. These are the substances which get fired easily, and that kind of the substance is known as combustible substance. Non-combustible substance are the kind of the substance which cannot get fired easily, cannot catch fire easily, are known as non-combustible substance. And examples: iron nail, water, stone. These are the some basic non-combustible substances which not get fired easily. Now, we are going to talk about the combustion. We have talked about fire, we talked about combustible and non-combustible till now. Now I am going to discuss about combustion. What is combustion? Basically, it is a chemical process in which substance get fired and produce heat and light and also new products are pumped, and this kind of the things are known as combustion. This combustion, when this combustion take place, the kind of the things which burn, that means substance which burn, it is known as fuel. During this process, the substance which burn are called fuel. The substance which burn are called fuel. The fuel which burn are gives flame or over glow. It is the nature of the fuel. Whenever this fuel burn, either it gives flame or glow it. Like wood, petrol, kerosene gives glow, gives flame, but coal gives glow, or room heater also glows. So whenever the fuels are burned, it gives either flame or the substance glow. Now we are going to talk about the conditions which is required for combustion. Conditions which is required for combustion. Condition for combustion. Basically, there are the three things. There are three essential things required to burn. What are these? These are heat, fuel, and oxygen. If these things are present, then only the combustions are burning take place. If out of these three, if anything is absent, the combustions will not going to take place. I am going to discuss the one by one. Fuel. As we know that fuel is a kind of substance which burns, like coal, petrol and others which burn, these are the, if these things are not there, that means burning will not going to take place. So essential and minor requirement is to end substance which we want to burn, and that should be there. If that things are not there, the combustions will not going to take place. Now second thing is oxygen. Oxygen is another important thing which is required for the combustion. If there are a fuels are present, suppose that coal are there, any kind of fuel are there, but out of this coal is placed at place where there is no oxygen. If there is no oxygen and if we provide it fire, the coal will not burn. That means if the oxygen are not present at the particular place where the fuels are present, at that place the fire will not take place or combustion will not going to take place. So oxygen is another part. To understand of more about this oxygen, I would like to give some kind of the activity which you can perform at your home. Take two candles and burn it. What you now did, after this you covered one candle with the help of glass. With the help of glass, what you will observe, the candle which is opened place, kept at open place, are always giving a flame. But the candles which are covered with glass, what happened here, after some times you observe that the flames are going diminish and diminish. At the end of some time, after few seconds, the flames fuse off. That means what happened here, since this the outer oxygens which are around the candle was present, what we did with the help of this closed glass, I covered it and broken the coming oxygen till the time whatever the oxygens are present inside this glass, the flames are there. But after some times, when the flames, the oxygens get absorbed by this flame, the flames are diminishing, and after some time, few seconds, the flames off. That means if there is no oxygens are present, the flames cannot be, a combustion cannot be take place. Here, since these combustions are required some essential things, and that essential things is the combustible substance, and here the wax are there, and this wax come contact with the oxygens and start getting chemical process, and till the complete till the end of this wax, the chemical process take place and the flames or burning take place. So the another important point was oxygen, which is essential requirement to burn in any kind of the combustible substance. Now, last one is heat. If suppose that you have any kind of combustible substance like coal, or wood are there, and what you did, you put a dip this wood or coal into the water. After that, you placed these coal and wood where the oxygens are present. It is combustible substance, and now the fire, what happened, what you initially observed, it will take more time compared to previously, since the wood or coals are dipped in water, the temperature is cool, and because of the cool of the temperatures, it is not going to easily burn. So heat is so important factors to burn any kind of the substance. That means if these conditions, out of these three conditions, if anything are absent, the combustion will not take place. So most and primary requirement for combustion is all these factors. If out of these factors anything absent, the combustion is not going to take place. So it is all about conditions of combustion. Now the combustion is also, this combustible substance is also known as inflammable substances. The combustible substance is also known as, in another term, inflammable substance. Inflammable substance are the kind of the combustible substance which gets fired easily. It is a combustible substance which catch fire easily are known as inflammable substance. And the inflammable substance has a low ignition temperature. It has low ignition temperature. Now I am going to talk about ignition temperature. What do you mean by ignition temperature? The example of this inflammable substance are LPG, petrol, diesel, coal, wood. These are the inflammable substances. Now I am going to talk about ignition temperature. Ignition temperature. Basically, it is the lowest temperature at which substance gets fire. It is lowest temperature at which substance catches fire. It is the lowest temperature at which substance catches fire. This kind of temperature is known as ignition temperature. It is known as ignition temperature. It is known as ignition temperature. Now I am going to discuss about some kind of substance at which where the ignition temperature is low or high. Now I am talking about comparing about LPG and wood. Ignition temperature. LPG has low ignition temperature comparatively high ignition temperature. Coal comparatively required high ignition temperature. That means at the lowest temperature which is required to get fire is in LPG is very low, whereas in wood and coal the lowest temperature is comparatively high from LPGs. Now if you make a cup of keep cone type of cup from paper and these with this two cup of paper in put here some water in one cup paper cup now what you will do burn it now starting to burn this paper what we observe that the paper cup which is empty get burning easily, whereas the paper cup in which the waters are placed it start burning at high temperature and high temperature. That means the ignition temperature of this cup is very low, whereas ignition temperature of this cup is very high. So it is difference at what temperature, materials difference at what temperature is going to burn the kind of the substance. Now the another important things which we are going to discuss about types of combustion. I am just today giving types of combustion. There are the three types of combustions. One is known as spontaneous combustion. Second one is known as rapid combustion. And third type of combustion is known as explosive combustion. These are the three types of combustions spontaneous combustion, rapid combustion and explosive combustions. These we are going to discuss at next class. Till the time, whatever the things I discussed here, all the things note down in your copy, make your proper notes and also solve the NCERT questions. Now, thank you.